Really?
Oh, that's Sandstorm.
Yeah, that's a good one. You know the Slam Jam on the PlayStation?
Yeah.
Then you managed to do a mix of it with Carolyn.
You made this?
Yes. How did you make that? Logic Pro.
How much does it cost any money?
Everything is blown away, broken down. All I see is smoke and pieces. What's left is no more. I'm the last one standing. Where is everyone? I think it's the end of the world, but how am I still alive? I must be invincible to survive the apocalypse that happened.
Why? He's got the same score.
I must be invincible. I wish I could revive.
Trick attack?
Eight.
Someone gives it an 8? Okay.
Okay, that's good. I just wrote it in my face.
That's alright. But what did you think of it, Sam?
It's got more views than anything else.
Thanks. And that's understandable. Well, my advice is keep posting stuff. You'll get the views.
I'll think like...
How many views you got?
144 on this.
144?
Yeah.
Wow. Don't get better views on me.
So here's another problem as well in my model. So, unfortunately, I have discovered that there's an end clock. Now to fix this, or pretty much another way you can pretty much like add like a add like a an edgelet to this is very simple. You just select a polygon, and then under edit geometry, you go to slice plane, and pretty much it'll give me this. It'll pretty much give me this slice plane. I'm gonna rotate it by 90 degrees on the y-axis, and I'm gonna move it towards my geometry, or what I have selected of it. And then I'm gonna press slice. And then I'm gonna click off the slice plane, and then all I have to do is just simply just select these two vertices, and press Control Shift. And if you guys want to fix this up and actually make this easy, all you just simply have to do is just target both of these vertices. And boom, give it a try.
Yes.
All right. So, pretty much when we're done with that, I'm gonna collapse into a little folly, and I'm gonna send this actual model to you guys. So I'm going to export it. Just say export it, select it.
Hope it's not reset.
And I'm going to put this on. I'm going to save this as an OBJ and save this as. So I'm gonna send this to you guys guys should all have the OBJ. So if you guys want to import it into Max, just go to the Max.
Come
symbol,
on!
That's how you save it.
Nope.
Go
I
to
just keep
import
error.
And then select import non-narrative file formats into 3ds Max. Go to desktop and then just load up the stairs example. Press import. And I'm gonna, and it'll say, if I want to name it as new object, so I'll, of course, I'll save it as new object. There I have it. There's my model. Oh, done. So, time to visit Sam. Oh, it's okay. Don't worry about it. So what you do is you go to the.
Thank you.
Don't worry about that. Don't worry about that. I'll send you an example of that if you want to unwrap that. But that's really optional. We're just unwrapping kind of like the rest of the stairs. So go to the unwrap modifier. And we're going to select it by faces. And then we're going to press planar map.
So I click unwrap.
Yep, the unwrap modifier. Unwrap UVW modifier. And then you would just press planar map like we normally would. And I'm going to align this by Y. Yeah. So.
What about the other stairs?
Don't worry about them. Just make sure you have this stair selected with the triangulated geometry. What I'm going to do is I'm going to select these faces. I'm also going to do that on the other side too as well. You know what? I actually have a perfect idea. We're actually going to unwrap like half of it. So I'm gonna quickly collapse it, and then I'm just gonna delete like, and I'm gonna like select like the actual mesh.
Delete it.
Yeah, just delete half of it. Is what you do.
I'm sorry, I'm wasting time.
It's okay. Don't worry about it.
So I just delete the original stair.
Go into faces.
Okay, the original stairs here.
Faces.
Okay, just need to go into faces and go half the stairs.
Because what we're going to do is we're going to symmetry it when we're done with unwrapping like half of it. And we're actually going to merge it with the other UVs. That's what we'll do.
Did I just change its color? And,
oh no, don't worry if it's not green. Color really doesn't matter. As long, it depends on your preference. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna select like the actual stairs or the railing. Also select these faces at the back here.
Can you select the faces on the side?
Yeah, select the faces on the other side as well.
Just like all the faces on the railing?
Yeah. And then what we'll do is we'll go into the UV editor, right click, break. Oh, there's actually one more face I actually forgot about. Give me a sec. Face welded. So I'm gonna delete that face. And I'm gonna cap it.
What was that face again?
It's this face. Right here. So and plus it's an N-gon, so we can't use that, but I'm going to create like an edge, and I'm actually going to connect them to fix the geometry issue. It's that face right there. So.
Oh, come on.
Yeah, just continue on wrapping it. So it is almost 3, and what I'll actually do is I'll make a tutorial video this week, and actually show you guys how like to unwrap and retopologize like little polygonal objects properly. That's what I'll do in the modular set tutorials. So that's what I'll do.
One of my favorite characters from Elsword.
That's interesting.
Heather introduced me to that game, actually.
Have any of you heard of that game?
I've heard of that in chat before.
So what we're going to do is, pretty much just to fix this all up, just